today we are doing something super exciting. I am on what they call a fam trip, which is a familiarization trip, and it's part of the conference that I've just come from in Kalamata. And we are taking the train from this town to another town, and it is called the Odontos. I'm probably not saying that exactly correctly, but basically it's a very steep grade train, and it works on a series of teeth that you go up into the mountain with. So it starts here in this town on the northern side of the Peloponnese called Diakopoto, and then we go to Kalavryta. It takes about an hour. The town is super adorable, and actually you could take the train from Athens here. So this is a little bit further down from Kiato, if you know this part of Greece. We are on our way now. If you want to sit in a seat that has a full view, choose seat 112. As you can see over there, they're sitting in the doorway. The train track is only 750 millimeters wide. And it climbs from sea level to 720 meters, and it's about 22 kilometers long. So the ride is about an hour long from place to place. And you can kind of hear that it's a little bit loud with the screeching of the train tracks, but it adds to the charm. It's not a very expensive train ride. One ticket is $9.50 to go one way. We have arrived, and I'm so excited. This was probably one of the coolest things I have done in Greece. Absolutely love this. We are at our lunch stop, and they have goats, and there are babies. Oh. The lunch stop was actually a wine tasting hosted by the wine connoisseurs, and they had invited the winemaker to come, and the taverna owner made this wonderful meal to go with every single wine that was brought, and he really knew the wine really, really well. It was outstanding, as you can see from the food.
He founded it, he didn't really have anything to do with wine. He lived in Germany most of his life, but he wanted to come back one day, and he thought,
The best part now is down. It's a Greek salad inside the bread.
The cheese pie with this wine, keep some, and then with the next wine, try the cheese pie with marmalade from roses and the next wine.
We are now going to be going on a feta cheese making tour. It is barrel aged feta, which I actually haven't heard of, and there's a truck pulling in behind me or something. Nope, one of those little, I see it now. Anyway, but behind me over here, they're having a milk delivery. So all of the locals bring their milk here to be made into feta cheese. It's amazing. And here I am in my very sexy outfit to go on the feta factory tour. We had to wear this and two shoe coverings. And just so you know, this is not really something that's open to the public. They usually just take people from the dairy industry on these tours. So this is a super special occasion. This feta cheese is at least 70% sheep's milk and 30% goat max. They do make goat cheese here. They make about 100 tons of feta a day there during the peak season, and it takes 4 kilos of milk to make 1 kilo of feta cheese. If you happen to be in Greece, you can buy this cheese only at the Sklavenita supermarkets. We are now in Kalavryta, and we are here in the square, and we're staying at this wonderful hotel overlooking the church. And if you look this way, there's some beautiful mountains as well. And I have to show you this. So this is the giant balcony. It is bigger than my room. So you can't really go wrong when your balcony is bigger than your room, and it's really cute and rustic. And if you're coming here in the winter, because Kalavryta is a big skiing town, it actually has a fireplace. We are in luck. The church is open. It is the Holy Cathedral of the Assumption of the Virgin Mary. Look how beautiful the outside is. And it's in this beautiful square. Like, how amazing is this? Morning, guys. We are now at the Megaspilio Monastery. It is named that because it's a cave, so large cave. Apparently there is a large cave behind the monastery. It is up on this beautiful mountainside here in the Peloponnese. It was like a 10-minute drive from Kalavryta, so really amazing drive as well. Beautiful along the way. And then we are going to go to the Megaspilio Winery. Another winery. So, more drinking today. So, the monastery is the second oldest monastery in the world after the one in Sinai in Egypt. And it has been destroyed 5 times, but it was built originally in 362. And the last time it was destroyed was during World War II. This monastery was founded when they found an icon, and this is the cave in which they found the icon in. Tasting room, and you can actually see down into the other level where they're going to make the wine. So this is amazing.
A few words about the wines that we produce. In this vineyard, we produce 4 wines, which are indicated like a Megaspilio estate. And these are the only single vineyard from this vineyard wines. We have 3 more vineyards in the area, in a distance of 5-7 kilometers from here. And from these vineyards, we produce a few more wines, which are indicated just Megaspilio.
So we have been served lamb with potatoes, and the lamb has been made with lemon, oregano, salt and pepper, olive oil, of course, and some garlic. And we also have cheese pie, a Greek salad, and some amazing cheese that we had earlier. We are now in the village of Zaroukla. I think I'm saying that close to correct. I will definitely spell these out for you, either in the title or in the description, but it's a really quaint mountain village. It's a very twisty, windy road to get here from Kalavryta, and we're staying in a beautiful mountain resort, and I'll give you a little tour of my room later. Not only is the village small, it's pretty quiet. So the mountain resort that we're staying at, Stiga, is down this road and about a couple of minutes walk up a beautiful road with lots of little rivers. I'll show you on the way back up. Here is the church. It doesn't look like church is open, but the little chapel outside is open. And it's like adorable. I definitely think this village is probably a little more happening in the winter, or maybe in the earlier spring. We've had a really cool spring, so it's probably still nice for hiking, but sometimes it's pretty warm by now. So imagine that hiking in the spring here is much nicer. I love all these stone houses though. But the village pretty much ends here. I'm sure the surrounding hills have houses that technically belong to the village, but that's it. It's probably, I don't know, a half a kilometer long. This is the road back up to the resort, and it's so beautiful through here. The greenery is stunning, and this whole village has a roar to it because there are streams everywhere. We are staying at the Stiga Resort. It's stunning. So here is the beautiful bathroom, giant shower stall, which I love, and big beautiful bed. And those pillows look like they are nice firm pillows, and I love nice firm pillows. Fireplace, because this is definitely a mountainous region. It's even chilly now. And look at this stunning balcony. Overlooking the village. Good morning, everybody. We are now at a lake in the Peloponnese, taking a small hike around the lake with a company called the Explore Peloponnese. The lake is stunning, and there are beautiful wildflowers everywhere. And we saw some people camping, and you can kayak across the lake as well. The lake was formed when there was a landslide and it blocked the river. So not really like a natural lake in the sense of how you could normally think of a lake, but very beautiful lake as a result. It has a stunning color. You're about to kind of see it come through here in the video. There it is. And it's about 80 meters deep at its deepest. Stunningly beautifully blue. What a beautiful weekend in the Peloponnese. This has been glorious. Absolutely stunningly beautiful. Sadly, it's over and I'm going back to Athens. So I will see you guys in the next video. I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks so much for watching.